Scenes from this week's Fort Meade Garrison Headquarters Company Battalion Change of Command. Lieutenant Colonel Thomas Chapeau relinquished command to Lieutenant Colonel Stephen Ward. Hello and welcome back to Meade Week. I'm Brian Spann. It's been nearly 4 months since our last show, and in that time it seems we've entered a whole new world. While there weren't a lot of events to cover since March because of COVID, there were a whole lot of changes we'll be talking about today and on subsequent shows. We start with a big change this week, lowering the health protection condition from HPCON Charlie to HPCON Bravo. In the June 29th town hall, Fort Meade Garrison Commander Colonel Erich Spragg talked about the transition to HPCON Bravo.
We ask that you not become complacent. That complacency, which we are witnessing in many states today, will take us right back to where we came from, which is an elevation in our HPCON status, which then forces the closure of services, shelters in place, and further travel restrictions. So please, protect yourself and your families, because we are relying on you to protect the nation.
You can watch the entire video or read a full transcript of the town hall. Both are available on the Fort Meade Facebook page. Through the months of dealing with COVID, one of the biggest issues has been childcare. The child development centers were closed in March, but are scheduled to reopen the first week of July. Basically, the CDCs will initially reopen to the highest priority customers, and depending on how things progress, the CDCs will expand service in stages. We spoke with MWR's Director of Child and Youth Services, Francisco Jamison, who says the CDCs will start phase one starting July 6th.
CDC 3 and School Age Center 1 will reopen. For about 175 children at those two facilities total. We'll wait 2 weeks to see how everything goes with both the pandemic in the greater Anne Arundel corridor, as well as our own protocols and procedures in CYS, and then we'll reopen two additional buildings at phase two, which is CDC 1 and School Age Center 2. We'll wait about 2 weeks, see how things are going, make sure everyone is safe and healthy, and then about 2 weeks after that, we will open our last two facilities, CDC 4 and the Youth Center. So all in all, it's about a six-week process, and we would be opening back up to about 450 kids.
Jamison adds that in phase two, CYS will resume in-home family child care as well. He also says that the situation is fluid and subject to change.
None of us have been here before. This is brand new to all of us. So child care was a difficult proposition before, both in gaining child care, but also just conducting it. Child care is a very taxing profession, you know. So I ask for their patience. The number one thing I can ask for right now going forward is their patience. Please be patient with the process. Please be patient with my staff.
Meanwhile, let's take a look at some of the MWR services that are reopening. Let's start with the gym. Gaffney Fitness Center is set to open Monday, July 6th. It'll be open to active duty service members only. There are some other restrictions as well, including a one-hour time limit, a maximum capacity of 120 customers, and no showers, locker rooms, pool, or sauna. Outdoor Rec is also scheduled to open July 6th. Customers must wear a face mask while inside the facility and observe good social distancing. There are other limitations as well. The Family Pet Care Center opened July 1st for daycare and boarding. They have a new set of procedures in place for dropping off and picking up your pet. The Lanes Pro Shop opened this week as well, with masks required for all customers. The Lanes Pin Deck Cafe is scheduled to reopen on July 6th for curbside pickup and outdoor dining. Arts and Crafts opens July 6th. To reduce foot traffic, they're taking framing, engraving, and graphic design projects on by appointment only. Located in the same building, Leisure Travel Services is opening July 13th. They encourage customers to make ticket orders over the phone. Phone messages left should be answered within 24 hours. Auto Skills is reopening on Wednesday, July 8th. The While You Wait Wednesday service is going to be by appointment only. Masks will be required at all times inside the center. And finally, the Medal of Honor Library is scheduled to open on July 13th with a maximum capacity of 15 customers. And finally this week, a personal note. On June 25th, we published the final issue of the Soundoff newspaper. In publication for more than 71 years, the Soundoff has been, for the most part, our first source of community news. And as we published the last issues of the paper, it was hard not to think about the Soundoff staff and the relationships that we've developed over the years. In particular, I've worked with two of them for my entire 13-year tenure here at Fort Meade Public Affairs. To Rona Hirsch and Lisa Rhodes, I just want to say thank you for everything you've done for me and the Fort Meade Public Affairs Office. I'm going to miss you both dearly. We have a small family here at Public Affairs, and each party is really felt. Your party is going to leave a huge hole. Best wishes to both of you, and God bless. And that's Meade Week for this week. I'm Brian Spann. For everyone at Meade TV and the Fort Meade Public Affairs Office, have a great weekend and a great Meade Week.